Hi, this is Tasos Piotopoulos, and welcome to Section 5, a restaurant menu API with Redis. Overview of the menu API. In this video, we are going to look into the system design and supported operations of a service that exposes a restaurant menu. As part of the design, we will make a quick introduction to the Azure building blocks and external dependencies we are going to use for the implementation. Let's walk through the menu API design and see what is involved. A user can invoke the menu API, which is a Spring Boot project, to get a collection of menu items. Each item includes a name plus an image URL. The example use case here is that we don't hold images of menu items in our system, but rather we call the third-party service to get a random image for a given category. To construct a response, the API has to first connect to a database and run a query. The result of that query contains entries, each one having a name and a category image URL. Next, it has to call the random image service once for each menu entry, and finally map these results to the appropriate DTO to return to the user. Let's imagine that apart from the image service calls being slow, we also have a limited amount of allowed calls to that service per minute. To overcome these problems and optimize how we handle our user requests, we will introduce a caching layer using a service called Azure Redis Cache. The cache will be able to remember the most recent response of the menu API and return the same one for all subsequent requests. Note that we won't use an actual SQL database, but rather a mock implementation, so we can focus on the Redis part. If we were to use a real database for the menu, Azure offers a number of great choices, for example, Postgres and Microsoft Azure SQL, which we would easily consume from Java using standard data access methods, such as the Hibernate ORM framework.